Hello, everyone. I'm Craig Williams with your Diz Daily Fix for Thursday, June 8th, 2017, and here's what's happening today. First up, Star Wars fans out there, I've got some big exciting news for you. This morning, Disney Parks blog announced that a Star Wars Land Pavilion will be happening at this summer's 2017 D23 Expo. So what should we expect from Walt Disney Parks and Resorts, a galaxy of stories? Well, we should be seeing an inside look at the locations, starships, creatures, and droids that will populate the remote village on the Outer Rim, including a detailed model. So if you were at the last D23 Expo in 2015, you might remember that they had an entire pavilion dedicated to Shanghai Disneyland, as well as a little small pavilion dedicated to Pandora, the world of Avatar. Inside the Pandora one, they had a detailed model of what the land would look like, and it was super stunning. And I can only imagine that this one will be even better, because I'm sure they're giving it a lot of love. On top of that, of course, they're going to have on Saturday afternoon, Bob Chapek will be giving the announcement of everything that's to come in the parks and resorts. So expect to hear even more details about Star Wars Land then, as well as Toy Story Land's grand opening date and all that goodness. So you have that to look forward to in a couple weeks. Make sure you're following along with us for all of it, because we will be there and we will be cranking out videos for you left and right. So moving on to Universal, actually, I have to say something about it. Universal Studios Japan broke ground on Super Nintendo World just late last night, early this morning. Time zones. It's weird. You know that. But during the presentation, the most exciting part was that Mark Woodbury from Universal Creative announced that Mario Kart would be coming to their Super Nintendo World. So that is very exciting, because, you know, we're all speculating that whatever Universal Studios Japan gets in their Super Nintendo World, that we will also get in ours. So that is just something to look forward to. He's saying that Mario Kart will be a new kind of attraction that takes theme park entertainment to an entire new level, and I'm sure it will blow us all away. So they also released a little teaser video that went along with it that showed Mario entering through the warp tube and then just being inside of Super Nintendo World. So maybe we're going to enter in through a warp tube. That would be my hope, kind of like how you have to, how you enter Diagon Alley in a secretive way. Maybe you'll do this one the same exact way, but I am very excited. Super Nintendo World will open in 2020 at Universal Studios Japan, and then after that for Hollywood and Orlando. So finally in the news, not as important, but here in Orlando, over at Splitsville, the bowling alley on the west side of Disney Springs, it just opened a brand new enclosed second story bar. So the bar has a great view of Disney Springs from what I'm being told, and it still features all those great items on Splitsville's menu. So all I can say is I hope we get out there really soon to check it out. We love bar hopping around Disney Springs, so we will have to make a stop at this brand new one, especially on a rainy day, since it's enclosed. That'll work out. So let's move over to the Diz. Today's featured article comes from Genevieve Roberts, as she shares some tips for meeting Disney characters as an adult. All I can say is I will have to go read that article over at wdwinfo.com, because I am always completely uncomfortable meeting characters as an adult. Now, over on Dizboards.com today, FastPass Plus seems to be one of the hottest topics. So, in a thread entitled "Tapping Out at FastPass Touchpoint Still Okay," poster Chasing Leslie wants to know if people still tap their Magic Band at the front of a FastPass Plus attraction so it will be marked as used and they actually don't use it as a way to access a fourth FastPass Plus sooner than normal. So I didn't know this was a thing. That's why I sound so confused reading it. Gosh, people will do anything to cheat the system, and they're very weird. But stop by our theme parks, attractions, and strategies forum over at Dizboards.com to join that discussion and learn more. Now, today on the Diz Unplugged Universal Edition, myself and Rhino Clavin will be talking all about the latest news at Universal, including more in-depth coverage on that Super Nintendo World groundbreaking, tickets for Halloween Horror Nights, Fast and Furious Supercharged, and then we spend a little bit time discussing the Universal Dark Universe cinematic universe that's about to debut tomorrow with The Mummy. So you can find that at disunplugged.com or youtube.com/disunplugged. Now, closing things off with the weather. Out in Anaheim, you can expect partly cloudy and sunny skies today and tomorrow with temperatures right at 76 and lows right around 60. Now, here in Orlando, still expect more scattered showers today with temperatures at a nice 82 and a low right around 70. But tomorrow, we get a break from the rain. We're going to have partly cloudy skies, and the high is going to rise to 87 with a low of 73. So for links to all the things discussed in today's Diz Daily Fix, please visit the Daily Fix main page at wdwinfo.com/dailyfix. That's going to do it for me today, but we will be back with you tomorrow for the next installment of the Diz Daily Fix. Have a great day, everyone.